Hey everyone, welcome back. And today I am going to present to you my second 10x10 capsule wardrobe. And this is actually in collaboration with another sustainable sister. So as I've said, this is a collaboration with another sustainable sister, and that is Layana Franco, the CEO and founder of the community called Swap a Porter. Or if you're going to call it like how they pronounce Net-a-Porter, then it will be Swap a Porter. Okay. And so we decided that we were going to collaborate because we're both into sort of like slow fashion, sustainable fashion, wearing what you have and finding ways to wear what you have in unique ways so that it's never boring. So what we've done is we've chosen 6 items from our wardrobe, and each of us would need to choose 2 items from that 6 items that the other person would need to incorporate into their 10x10. So in my case, Layana has chosen for me my sort of like rust red off-shoulder top and my black linen maxi dress, which I will show you after this sort of like intro. Okay, so yeah, that's what we decided to do, and I'm going to go ahead and link her video somewhere up here. I'm not actually sure where it's going to appear, but it's that I button. So click on that if you want to watch her video after you watch mine, of course. And then I've also put in her social media and her channel in the description box down below, so you can go ahead and follow her wherever she may present herself. But before I go into actually showing you the items that I have picked out for my 10x10 challenge, I wanted to talk to you about what were some of the things that I had learned from my first capsule wardrobe 10x10. So first thing is to always check the climate or the weather in the next couple of days, whatever the forecast is, because that was one of the things that really didn't work for me in that first capsule wardrobe, and in hindsight I knew I could have done better. Was that in that capsule wardrobe I had like a pair of jeans. I think there might have been 2 pairs of jeans in that capsule wardrobe, 2 knitted jumpers or sweaters or pullovers, however you want to call them depending on where you are in the world, and 2 long-sleeved shirts plus a coat. So it's very sort of like still winter, mild winter or chilly spring kind of vibe that I chose. But during that 2 weeks that I was going to do that, it was actually very warm. So yeah, so that in fact was a massive, massive fail. And also the thing that happened with me there was that I didn't choose enough variety in terms of the items in the wardrobe or the capsule wardrobe, so that it felt like I was just repeating the outfits just with different color combinations, but pretty much the same look. So it wasn't as exciting, it wasn't as fun to dress with that. And to be honest with you, midway, because it was just sweltering hot, that there were like days that were like 29-30 degrees Celsius in the middle of spring. Actually, in the beginning of spring. So I ditched my jeans for shorts and I ditched my long sleeves for t-shirts. So yeah, so that's one of the things that you need to like be careful about, is like look at the weather forecast. Choose enough variety so that you don't get bored with what you have. And also in that capsule wardrobe, I chose 10 items of clothing, not including the shoes. In this one, I have 8 items of clothing and 2 shoes. So that comprises my 10x10. Now, without further ado, okay, let's get into the looks. Okay, so here are the 10x10 capsule wardrobe options that I have decided on. So I do have one on, which is a white t-shirt and a pair of blue jeans. But to start off, we have here a Susie Tompkins large linen dress. You can see it's like really long. It's a maxi dress. But anyway, this one, I remember the seller for this one. This is Unicorn Finds, I believe. or is it thrifted unicorn? Anyway, I'll put it in the description box below. If you are based in Australia, I would suggest that you look up these people. Okay. But this is an off-shoulder, sort of like a rusty red top that if you are sort of adventurous, you could probably use it as a really short dress as well. So yeah, that one's secondhand as well. This one was bought new about 3 years ago. This is my Esprit striped cotton, organic cotton t-shirt. Yeah, it's about 3 years ago. I love the details of the buttons on one shoulder. This one is also an organic cotton t-shirt that's got a lot of lint on it. It's a black one from Target, Australia. This one is bought this. And then I have this. This is, I believe this is a Uniqlo. Yes, confirmed. This is a Uniqlo pleated skirt. It's one size smaller. It says 26 to 27. I'm usually a 28 in a Uniqlo, but because it has an elasticated waist, it doesn't really bother me. I got this secondhand from Vinny's at Glebe. Okay, so Vinny's at Glebe. And I think it was like $8 or something like that. So this is my Levi's denim. It's an XL, so this is pretty oversized on me. I'm usually a medium. Sometimes I pass off as a small as well. But when I saw this at the Glebe markets, I fell in love with the way the denim faded. And I think I got this for $50. Okay, so that's that. And then I included two pairs of shoes. One is a really old pair of Converse that I have had since 2014, so about 6 years old now. And another one is a secondhand purchase, which is more like a rusty brown shade. This is by Oriton. As you can see, the previous owner has really used it, but the leather is still pretty good. Okay, so first of all, excuse the microphone. I'm gonna take this off when I start doing the time lapse of the change. But I wanted to show you first the first outfit since I didn't show the t-shirt and the jeans earlier. So I thought I'd do that. I'm wearing the Oriton boots, as you can see, and I cuffed the jeans to show off a little bit of my leg as well, because I think it looks a little bit more elongating if I do that as opposed to having the jeans down like so. It kind of cuts me off, I think. It makes my legs look shorter than they already are, so I like to cuff this when I'm wearing an ankle boot. I learned this from Elizabeth May, I think is her name. I'm gonna link her channel below because she's another sustainable or slow fashion sister based also in Melbourne like Liana is. So yeah, and she actually works as a model. So I'm not sure if it's full-time or part-time, but she works as a model. So I thought, you know what? If I'm gonna take tips, I'm gonna take tips from somebody who's a professional in the fashion industry. So anyway, this t-shirt is a new to me, well, a couple of months old. It's a Uniqlo Supima cotton t-shirt, and I got it in the size medium from the men's section because I like, because it's sort of like the loose fitting t-shirt. I've got the brown belt, which I didn't show you as I was doing the filming, and this belt is vintage, well, not vintage, secondhand from U-Turn Vintage. There you go. Okay, so this pair of jeans is my only pair of skinny jeans. It's not even like completely skinny. But this is by Armani. And I got this from TK Maxx. I've been wearing it to death. I've had it for like 3 years now. So yeah, it's not new, but it was bought new. Okay. And since we're at it, I'll probably come in a little bit closer to show you what my... I'm just gonna push this a little bit to the side so it's not taking away. Yeah, there you go. I'll show you my jewelry that I'm wearing as well. Okay, so earrings is a gold hoop I think they call it a huggy. Okay, it's a gold hoop that I bought in Qatar, in Doha, Qatar, back in 2009, I think it was, when I was still working there. There we go. Yeah, when I was still working in Doha, Qatar. So this is like, I think this is 24 karat gold. necklace is one that I wear every day, and it's got my initials and Duncan's. It's a monogram necklace. That's it says D and M. So D is Duncan, my husband, and this was his gift to me back in 2012 on my 31st birthday. This was when we first got together. Watch is Mark by Marc Jacobs. I've had this since 2013. We bought it in Perth in Western Australia when we first moved back to Australia. And wedding ring, of course. There you go. So this is the first outfit. Now, how am I going to change this up? Whatever combination I did with the white t-shirt could also be done with the black t-shirt and the striped t-shirt. So that is definitely more than 10 outfits with 10 items, including shoes. All right, so I hope you enjoyed the looks that I presented to you guys and found some inspiration in how you can use your clothing and not be bored with it. You can really think of unique ways to actually utilize a piece of clothing in the normal, usual way that they're used. Just as how I did with a skirt, how I did with that off-shoulder top, and how I did with that linen dress. Okay. So, without any more blah blah, thank you very much for watching. I hope you subscribe, like if you liked it, share it. And if you haven't already, if you do subscribe, please click on the notification bell so that you know when I upload videos. And I think that's pretty much it. I hope you have a nice day. Bye.